Okay guys, we are here for the trek to Surkanda Devi temple. It is about 1 to 1.5 kilometers trek, bit of steep is involved, and it is about 9,000 feet above sea level. Okay, so we are up the steep. The distance is not much, but it is a pretty steep slope. Let's see if we find some mules to ride along to the top. Ashvik and his mom has also started the ascent. You will fall short of breath due to the less concentration of oxygen. What a view. You can see the Himalayan range from here. The temple offers a 360 degree breathtaking view of the Shivalik range, and I'll also tell you the story once we reach the top. Ashvik's grandpa, having full resolve, and they have made it. Ashvik's grandma is atop the mule. It cost about 400 rupees to go up and another 400 rupees to come down per person. Ashvik's grandpa. This is a ropeway which is under construction. Hopefully it finishes early. Would be a lot of convenience for the elderly. Okay, here is the story. I'll also narrate it once we are going on top. Okay, the story goes like this. So Brahmaputra, God King Daksha, his daughter is Sati Devi. So Sati Devi and Lord Shiv are married to each other, and Daksha does not approve of that marriage. Okay, so King Daksha does not approve of their marriage, and during the Yajna, he does not invite Lord Shiv to the Yajna. So Sati Devi is really angry about that, and she immolates herself in the Yajna, and that makes Lord Shiv really angry. And then he starts to do the Tandav Nritya. As you all know, the Tandav is essentially the dance of destruction. And what he says is, he vows that he will not stop Tandav Nritya till the body or the corpse of Sati Devi Mata gets completely decomposed. So that would really mean literally the end of the world, because you know that the Tandav is a very strong form of dance, and if it continues for such a long period, it may lead to the annihilation of the world as we know it. So all the gods, they go to Lord Vishnu, they say to Lord Vishnu that we need to find a solution for this. And what Vishnu does is, he comes with his Sudarshan Chakra, and he hurls the Sudarshan Chakra towards the corpse of Sati Devi Mata, and all the bits and pieces of the corpse fly in different directions. About 51 pieces land in various areas around India. These are known as the 51 Siddhapit or Shakti Pit. These are areas of tremendous significance in our mythology or in our history, so as to see. So this is one of the Siddhapeeth or Shaktipeeth. This is where the head of Sati Devi Mata landed. So it is known as Sirkandha or Sarkandha, which later became as Surkandha Devi. So as you know, this Devi later took up the physical form of Parvati Devi. So the relation was still maintained. So that is the story of Surkandha Devi Mata. It has a very positive vibe, being a Shaktipeeth or Siddhipeeth. Okay, so Ashwik and his mom has taken a pit stop. There are lots of benches in the middle where you can rest. You can go for the mule option, but then you'll miss out on the trek. It's about 2750 meters high above the sea level. That is roughly about 8000 to 9000 feet above. Still ascending, about halfway through. So Ashwik's mom and Ashwik has finally given up. They are on the way on a mule. It's a pretty steep trek. Mules are advisable. Okay, after a gruesome trek, no denying that, we are almost here. Still a few steps to go. Mr. Mule is busy enjoying. After that gruesome trek, I've caught some breath and look at this view. Just have a look at this. Amazing. The entire Shivalik range. There is no better view than this. This is the temple, Surkandha Devi temple. Absolutely breathtaking views here. This is the Shivalik range. You can see the various peaks. It's the Bandarpuch peak and Kalanag peak. So legend goes that Bandarpuch is the tail of Hanumanji after Hanumanji set fire to Lanka. He flew all the way and extinguished his tail at this peak. And below that, behind that peak is the Kalanag peak. This is the Shivalik range, that is Shiv, traces of Shiv, Lord Shiv. And this is the outer Himalayas. The inner Himalayas are known as the Himadri Himalayas. This is the outer Himalayas, that is the Shivalik Himalayas. Let's have a 360 view of the temple. The trek was worth it, but I'll definitely recommend to make use of the mules. It's a influence of Tibetan culture in the temple design. Absolutely breathtaking. At 9000 feet, Ashwik's mom enjoyed the trek up. And Ashwik has enjoyed as well. Ashwik! An absolutely breathtaking Himalayas, Shivalik range. Wonderful. Once in a lifetime experience. The temple is closed for some minutes. On the other side. Okay, we are now at Thierry Lake. The coat is off, the ear cap is off, it's not that cold anymore. The view is really nice, you can do boating here. There is jet ski, various types of boating, banana ride. I'll just show you the shark, various water sports activities. A bit on the higher side, I feel, but it's the official rates of the government. Small kids play area, and Ashwik has already started the stuff. Hi, Ashwik. Chana. Hello. What a nice view. You can see the entire lake. Beautiful. Beautiful. So we have kind of decided against doing the water sports. Basically, we will be visiting the Thierry Dam as well. It is some 5-10 kilometers from this place. It's India's largest dam and one of the largest dams in the world, at 900 feet tall. Ashwik has enjoyed a lot on this slide. Ashwik, say hi to the camera. Ashwik?
Say hi.
Hi.
Yes.
Hey guys.
Now hey, where you are going now?
Thierry Dam.
Thierry Dam.
Very good. Okay, we are at the Thierry Dam. This is the largest dam in India, about 900 feet. This is all you can see. To visit the dam, you require a permit if you want to see the dam from inside. Those electric cables you can see, that provides the hydroelectricity. This dam is maintained by the Thierry Hydro Development Corporation, that is THDC, and it was conceptualized by Shri Jawaharlal Nehru back in 1961. Design was complete by 1972, and construction started in 1978. And the funniest part is that it completed construction in 2006. So almost 28 years for the functioning to start for this dam, due to lots of protests, environmental reasons and social reasons. And now it has a capacity of 1000 megawatt electricity. Electricity is supplied to Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Chandigarh. So, nice spot. You can visit inside, but you need a permit from the district magistrate. It's a big formality, takes 2-3 days. This is what it is. Another reason for the opposition was Bhagirathi being a sacred river for the Hindus, so there was a lot of opposition. This dam is built on the Bhagirathi river. You'll see some cables here where the electricity is transmitted. So this is the Tiari Dam, largest dam in India and one of the largest in the world. Decent experience. We wish we could have gone inside, but we require a separate permit for that. The district magistrate. And that would be about it for the day. Tomorrow we are going to visit Mussoorie and Kempty Falls. Cheers.